Hello dear students, once again welcome back. So as we know, we are discussing our lesson and the name of our lesson is what? Methods of preserving food. In that, in our previous lecture we have discussed about how the food get entered into the how the microorganisms get entered into the food, which are the favorable set or the which are the favorable condition for the growth of a microorganism, which is the favorable favorable condition for the growth of microorganism. The favorable state is what? The microorganisms need proper amount of food, water, air and warmth. Okay, so these are the some conditions which needs the microorganisms to grow on a particular area. Okay, so when the microorganisms get entered into the foodstuffs get spoiled or contaminated. But how to preserve the food from these all microorganisms activity? So for that, today we will start our next sub point, that is nothing but what? Methods of food preservation. Okay, so today we will discuss about the different methods of food preservation. So let's start. The first method of the food preservation is drying. Okay, so the drying is the method in that what we are doing, we are allowing the foodstuffs or we are drying the foodstuffs into the sunlight. Because of the heat, what happened? Whatever the microorganisms are present in that, they all get killed because of the heat of the sun. Okay, so in this way we can preserve the food for the long period of the time by using the method drying. And this drying is the method of preservation is used by the foodstuffs, like we are making the papars during the summer season. Papar, kurda is also one of the food sample or the food stuffs like that. Also we can dry the wheat and the dal in the sunlight properly. Okay, so that wheat and all we are drying during the summer season, and that dried wheat and different types of the grains and the dals we can use for the remaining period or for the remaining whole year. Okay, so this is about the drying. In the drying we are providing the heat to the food stuff which kills the microorganisms which are present in them, because as we know, warmth is also necessary for the growth of the microorganism, but excessive warmth is not good for the growth of the microorganism. Because of the excessive heat they get destroyed. Now the next method of food preservation we will discuss, that is nothing but what? Cooling. So if we keep the food stuff or the food material into the refrigerator, then that condition will be the not good for the growth of a microorganism, because as we know, in the freezer or in the refrigerator the temperature is less. Okay, or the in that there is a cool condition is the temperature is less, that's why the temperature is less and the cool condition is there, and that cool condition is not good for the growth of the microorganism. So the microorganisms will not grow into the foodstuffs and we can preserve our food. Okay, so as we know, if the food remains, if we are having the dinner, and in the dinner if the some foodstuff remains, then our mother is keeping that foodstuff into or the food atoms into the refrigerator, and in next day we can have that sometimes. Okay, so in this way, in the refrigerator the temperature is less, that is why what we can preserve the food material, that is nothing but which methods of preservation our mother is using, that is cooling. The cooling is not favorable condition for the growth of the microorganism, that's why we can preserve the food materials. Okay, now next one we will discuss the method of food preservation, that is boiling. So when we boil something, then it goes up till the higher temperature, and because of that higher temperature that microorganisms are get destroyed in there. Okay, so see, now it is the rainy season, so doctors are advise us that boil the water for the 10 minutes and then drink it. Why? Because of the boiling, whatever the microorganisms are present in that all get destroyed and we'll get the pure form of the water. Same with the different types of the food material also. If we will boil the milk for a long period of the time, then whatever the microorganisms are present in the milk all get destroyed. Okay, because of the overheat. Then and we can preserve our food material for the long period of the time. That is this method of preservation, that is boiling. Now we can say that the next method of food preservation, that is pressing in airtight cans. It is also called as cannings. Okay. So sometimes we are placing the food into the airtight cans. Okay. So before placing the food into the airtight cans, it should be, or it is very essential to remove or to kill all the bacteria which are present over in the food. Okay. And after that, very essential thing that we have to do that before canning or before closing the tin, that we have to remove. It is very essential to remove all the air or water which is present in the food, and then we have to pack that can. Why it is necessary to remove the water or air and the microorganisms from that? Because as we know, if the microorganisms will remain in that, then they will feed on the whatever the water is present in the foodstuff. And air is also good for the condition for the proper growth of the microorganisms. Okay, and slowly slowly the growth of microorganisms will get increased. Okay, and our food get spoiled, and then there is no any use of the canning. Okay, so in this way, before canning, before pack the food into the airtight cans, it is necessary to remove the excessive water, air, and it is need to destroy the microorganisms which are present in them. Okay. Also, after the canning, we should keep that canned food properly or into the proper place where there is no any types of the we can say the different types of the animals like ants, mice, rats, cockroaches, and all. Okay, and once you will open that canned food, then you have to finish it as early as possible, because as we open the lid of that can, then some air will go inside the can, and slowly slowly it will provide the favorable condition for the microorganisms. Okay, so this is the next method, that is nothing but what, placing in airtight cans, or it is also called as what, canning. So with the help of these cannings, we can get the different types of the pickles are there. Also we can get the ambras. Now it is the season of mango, so we are making the ambras and all that. So we are getting all these food stuffs into the cans. Okay, so this is the next method of the food preservation, that is placing in airtight cans. Okay, so with the help of these we can take different types of the seasonal fruits, or we can taste the different type of the seasonal fruits in any season. Okay, so this canning of the food is also helpful to preserve the food, because it not allow the favorable condition for the microorganisms to grow. Okay, so in this way, today we have discussed about the different methods of food preservation, that are what, drying, cooling, boiling, and placing in a airtight cans. Okay, so these are the different methods of food preservation that we are following. Now, so today I will end my point, and next point we will discuss in a next lecture. So for today, thank you.